Shop Talk. The video you just saw was on how sandpaper is made. So let's talk about the art of sanding. This is an area kids hate. They just hate the sand. They want to use a machine. They want to use something like this, which is an orbital sander, which the grade 7 and 8s love. Unfortunately, grade 6, you don't get to use any machines like this. It's all about old-fashioned hand sanding. So what is sandpaper made of? Well, from the video, you notice that they crushed garnet mineral. That what it does is makes little tiny, just about like seeds. It's the grain of salt or pepper. And they're very sharp, it's very tough. And that's why shop teachers like it, because it lasts a long time and it does a great job. Now, we have three groups here of sandpaper that we use at Rock Heights. So we have a coarse, a medium, and a fine, and this is my final finish that we use, and I use it for wet sanding. So over here with my 1680 grit sandpaper, we don't use it very often. We use 60 grit or 80 grit on my belt sander, and on the oscillating sander, this is for grade 7 and 8, we use 80 only. Otherwise, we don't use it very often. Too expensive, and so we just go directly to 100, 120, and then 150, 220. So back here at 100, that is mainly for pine. Once in a while, we'll use 80 with the hardwoods, but this is definitely for softwood, which is pine, and can be used for hardwood as well. Down below, we have 150 and 220, and that's for both deciduous and coniferous material. Now, the problem with using anything like this, of course, is to make sure that you break the back of the paper. So backing up a little bit, when you're given a piece of sandpaper, Mr. Green will say, break the back. You hold it by each corner and you do a diagonal bend. And when you're doing this, and you can hear maybe even the kind of the funny sound. And what it is that little bits of the little bits of sandpaper garnet material is actually floating off, and that way it won't get lodged into your wood. And then I just brush it off to knock off any other loose pieces. So that takes care of that. To review the last steps that I talked about, pine and spruce trees are softwood and they are coniferous, and we use 100 grit sandpaper when we want to sand them. The type of projects that we would do with those would be our grade 6 and 7, like toys, or the spoon, or the gumball machine. Now, carrying on to, again, grade 7 and 8, especially grade 8, we use hardwood. We use hardwood with cutting boards because it's very durable. You can use a knife on it and it won't scar too quickly. We have a little bit of maple, which is very popular. We don't like using red oak because it's what they call open grain, and food can get lodged. It can be problems with food safe, so we don't use that very often. And we use 80 grit. We start at 80 grit when we want to sand it, and we use the belt sander sometimes on that particular project. So I think that takes care of identification. So let's watch a short video on deciduous and coniferous trees and where they come from.